The House of Representatives Intelligence Committee says the Free Beacon has agreed to cooperate with its probe into Russian meddling into the election. The committee has also subpoenaed bank records from Fusion GPS. For more on the mystery and controversy surrounding the Trump dossier, I'm joined by Associated Press reporter Tom Lobianco. So for people who haven't been following as closely, this is a document that we started hearing about really in the fall of last year as the campaigns were in full swing.
That's right. I mean, there was some great reporting by Mother Jones where they interviewed who would later turn out to be Christopher Steele himself. It got lost in the mix at that point, but you know, as we see here, it's just an ever growing importance behind this document. And the, you know, the latest revelation was a big one, this connection with Free Beacon and potentially Paul Singer, the Republican billionaire, Republican donor, mega donor. You know, tons of drama involved here, an incredible amount of importance. And, you know, it ties, of course, right back into all the Russia investigations that we're seeing.
Now, the Trump administration, a lot of conservatives say this document was the basis for the entire Mueller investigation, right?
Yeah. So, and obviously there's a lot of spin and tugging and pulling from both sides on this. So that, you know, for their part, that's probably overstating it a little bit. But there is, you know, clearly there's been some interest in this document, and they do appear to be following certain threads out of this document.
Even if the sort of impetus for why this investigation by Christopher Steele, or why this was even created, or who funded it, the contents of what that dossier had in it, is that something that the Mueller investigation is looking into?
Well, here's what we know about the Mueller investigation right now. And it's interesting to put this in context here. So what, we're at the end of October right now. We have had this investigation for about 5 or 6 months now. Mueller's investigation, which takes over the federal investigation that had been going on for about a year. This thing is amped up significantly. We've seen interviews with Reince Priebus, Sean Spicer, by Mueller's investigators. We have seen him speak with Keith Kellogg, somebody who was very close with Michael Flynn. The grand jury interviewed Paul Manafort's spokesman. There was the FBI raid of Paul Manafort's home in Virginia. A lot has been going on. And how much of this ties back directly to that dossier, it's hard to say right now. Flynn and Manafort are definitely two key players that they're investigating. You know, there's a lot of extraneous threads that we see in this whole thing. You'll see a lot, multiple House and Senate investigations going on. Some will claim to be the Russia investigation. There's a lot of political back and forth on this. But in terms of keeping your eye on the ball, really watch what Mueller's doing. And he's become much more active in the last month or so, publicly so.
There were salacious bits in the dossier that haven't been verified or confirmed. But one of the overarching themes of the dossier is that the Russians meddled in the American election. And that, intelligence agencies have said, is a fact.
Yeah, I mean, that seems to be pretty much universally accepted at this point, with the stark exception of the president, of course. Of course, he has a political reason to fight back against that. But for everyone else, there seems to be a pretty wide acceptance that that is the case. You know, look, and we've seen evidence to that effect, too. We had the meeting that we discovered with Trump Jr., Paul Manafort, and Jared Kushner. And the Russian lawyer, Natalia Veselnitskaya. And we found out a little bit more about that this past week. Learned that the document that she had handed over to them in the meeting was very similar to a document put together by the Kremlin for Congressman Dan Rohrabacher, someone who U.S. intelligence had alerted Dan Rohrabacher himself that that they were trying to basically court him as a spy, trying to groom him. So, you know, look, we find out more and more the longer this goes on. Now, you know, was it effective? Did it swing the election? The White House will often say, well, you know, no votes were changed. Well, that's not one of the accusations that's out there. But the bigger question, did this influence the election? And was there collusion in the campaign between the Trump campaign and the Russian operatives? We don't have definitive answers on those yet. What we do know is that people are still pulling on these threads, and we constantly find out more. So, you know, is this at the beginning, the finish, the middle? It's hard to tell, but it sure feels like this could go on for a while.
All right. Associated Press reporter Tom Lobianco joining us from Washington today. Thanks so much.
Thank you.